office is a public trust. In other words, public officers and employees must at all times be accountable to the people. In line with this, Madam Chair, with all due respect, I wish to invite the attention of the committee to the press interview of Her Excellency, Madam Vice President, in the Senate on August 22, 2024. In substance, the Vice President said, "Saan naman kayo nakakita? Constitutional body, inuutusan isubmit ang audit report. Hindi pa nga tapos." With all due respect, Madam Chair, may I request the resource speaker to comment on her intention about her statement.
Madam Vice President.
Madam Chair, again, the question is not related to the 2025 Office of the Vice President budget proposal. On the issue of confidential funds, we have received audit actions regarding the confidential funds of the OVP. We have submitted our responses and we assure our full cooperation with the ongoing audit.
Honorable Luisito.
Madam Chair, in other words, this representation wished to be clarified when the Vice President made the statement, intention ba ng ating Vice Presidente na ibahagi o hindi ibahagi sa publiko ang resulta ng nilalaman ng audit report patungkol sa kontrobersyal na 125 million na confidential fund? Nonetheless, Madam Chair, I understand that the Vice President already expressed her intention not to answer this question. Thus, please allow this representation to shift to the COA. May I request the COA to give his comment to this statement of the Vice President?
Ask him, Juliano.
Madam Chair, pwede po pakiulit po yung question.
Okay, may repeat the question. Hindi po natin isasama sa yung 5 minutes.
During the press interview of the Vice President in the Senate on August 22, 2024, she made a remarks, "Saan naman kayo nakakita, constitutional body, inuutusan to submit fraud audit? Hindi pa nga tapos." We are requesting the COA to make their comment on this.
Madam Chair, ang sagot ko po siguro in relation dun sa subpoena kasi yung rationale po noong compliance namin sa subpoena, i-quote ko lang po yung second page po per sa sentence noong subpoena. "This subpoena duce tecum is being issued in accordance with the oversight function of the House of Representatives. This order is likewise based on Section 3 of COA Circular 2013-006 dated September 2013. Ang compliance po ng COA ay dahil po ito ay inisyo po ng chairperson ng Committee on Appropriations. And under yung pong Congress, yung House of Representatives, is a body authorized by law to issue subpoena. And we cannot interpret otherwise. There is a presumption of regularity and validity do sa subpoena. We cannot unilaterally challenge the validity of the subpoena unless the court will interpret that pwede po or hindi pwede. Yun po yung aming ko. Kaya kami po in-entrust po namin sa dun sa House of Representatives, dun sa wisdom po ng leadership, yung compliance sa documents. At ito rin yung sinasabi dun sa aming guidelines, na pag may subpoena po, we have to comply.
Honorable Luisa.
In relation to your compliance with the subpoena, did you recall having received any feedback from the office of the Vice President pertaining to the same?
Actually po, mayroon pong sulat ang Office of the Vice President sa aming chairman na yun nga po, may mga legal issues po na binabanggit. At ito po yung na-consider na rin po ng Office of the Chairperson noong nag-comply sa subpoena doon sa STECOM.
Madam Chair, with that manifestation of the COA, may I request that the committee be provided with a copy of the letter? And having said so, Madam Chair, may I request for a suspension of the briefing?
Briefing suspended. Thank you.